Today I'd like to talk about the relationship between fear and power. If you stuff it, hide it, and deny it, it's not going to go away and it will keep you stuck. Hi, my name is Ingrid H. Turner. I'm the spiritual advisor here at Corporate Hippie Connection. My background is in marketing technology, but some years ago I took a hard right turn and dove deeply into spirituality, spiritual expansion, intuition development, and have since circled around to merge the two, business, entrepreneurship, and spirituality, and that deep inner trusting your own intuition. Bringing these two together is a passion of mine, and I am so happy to be here today to share a little bit of my experience with you on this matter. So, today I'd like to talk about the relationship between fear and power. Fear is directly proportionate to the amount of power we are able to wield. So what that means is when you're feeling afraid, you're feeling a sort of shadow version of the power that is available to you in this lifetime. And you're watching this, and you're a go-getter, and you have big plans, and you have big dreams, and you are building, and you are producing something great for this world. So I want to talk to you about when that fear shows up for you. People who have a lot of power behind them, who have a lot of drive and ambition and know that they're here for something bigger than themselves, to provide something for the world that's going to last beyond their lifespan, they can tend to be afraid of their fear, right? Sounds like two negatives, but it does in fact create a positive. So when you're afraid of your fear, when you're afraid to show your fear, you think that your fear takes away from your power, but the truth is the fear is a mirror of your power. So when you feel that fear come up, the tendency can be to deny it, run from it, stuff it, do whatever it takes so that you don't have to focus on it or face it. And you want to focus on, oh, no, let's get things done. You know, let's make stuff happen, let's build. But what I want to share with you today is when that fear comes up, and you know, having fear inside of you doesn't mean that it's going to be present all the time or on the forefront all the time. You're going to be building and in your flow and in your zone and making things happen and building things of great import in this world. I know you are. But sometimes that fear is going to rear its ugly head and you may want to run from it and you may want to push it down and you may succumb to it. You know, but here's when the fear shows up. The fear shows up when you are right about to expand in your power. This is energy we're talking about here. So when you're going through an internal expansion, the first thing you're going to feel is a contraction. You're going to feel the fear come up really strong. And what you need to do in order to move into that new empowered way of living, into the next version of you, into the next version of your creation, you've got to be able to look that fear in the face and move through it. The trick is not to take it personally. Your fear doesn't say anything about you except that you have a lot of power on the other side of it. And here's the thing about fear. Fear is an ego response to that next level expansion because the ego is here trying to keep you safe, trying to like manage you. If you get too big and too powerful and too visible, then the ego's like, wow, that's a really big target on your back. Let's take it down a notch, huh? Knock you out at the knees, okay? Let's stay nice and safe and contained. And this is gonna be true for you no matter what you have accomplished in this lifetime already. You could be CEO of a Fortune 500 company, or you could be a tech entrepreneur bootstrapping it at the beginning of your journey. This fear is gonna come up for you when your next level expansion is available to you. Okay, and you're gonna have to move through that fear. You're gonna have to move into that fear, not away from that fear. And again, away from the fear can look like tamp it down, ignore it, pretend it's not there. But the results of pretending your fear is not there, of trying not to be afraid, of dismissing your fear and not admitting your fear to yourself or to anybody else, the result is you stay stuck in the current melee of your energy. Okay, you stay where you are and you're a go-getter. You've got big work here. You're a big energetic human and you're not going to be content staying where you are no matter where you are. Okay, there's a constant expansion that is available for you, a constant expansion that is begging to move forth from you, begging, okay? So I really want you to step up and to look this fear in the eye. And I want you to look at it. I want you to say, I see you. I honor you. I see what you're trying to do here. You're trying to protect me. Now we're gonna take this fear and we're gonna put it in the back seat. Okay? You say, I'm driving. Appreciate you. You can be the sidekick, you know, the backseat driver maybe. Tell me if I miss a turn, but I'm gonna drive from now on. Because your fear is just your ego getting out of control. Now our ego gets a bad rap, especially in the spiritual world. You know, when you play in that world for quite a while, it's like people like to use the ego as a club to beat each other. But that's not what I'm doing here. Your ego is here for a purpose. It is your ego that lets you know what you are available for. That you are meant to be here to provide something bigger for this world, to build something incredible, something that will outlast your lifetime. That's the positive ego manifestation. But the negative ego manifestation happens when that fear comes up and it goes, whoa, okay, you've done enough. Take it down a notch. Well, I need to protect you. I need to protect you. Not like that. So put it in the back seat and really acknowledging your fear and thanking your fear and getting into gratitude for your fear. Radical gratitude for your fear, for the ugly emotions come up, for the tears, for the struggle, for the frustrations. When you can look at that and you can say, you know what, thank you, because I know what you're telling me. I know what you're telling me. You're telling me that I have massive potential and I appreciate that. Now I'm gonna put you in the back seat and I'm gonna go ahead and move towards that potential. And that is when you reach your next level expansion. And it might take you a little bit to move through that fear, to get to the place where you can be thankful, where you can be grateful for the fear showing up and giving you this message and letting you know that you are about to pop into a whole new paradigm of you. Your business is about to expand. Your creations are about to expand, to come to fruition. You as a human are about to expand into the next level powerful version of you. All right, that's an incredible message. Go ahead and give yourself a few days, a couple of weeks if you need to really be in that feeling, in that fear, and practice being grateful for that message. If you stay with it and stay in it, what's gonna happen is you're gonna move through the fear and then you're gonna be able to release it. If you stuff it, hide it, and deny it, it's not gonna go away and it will keep you stuck and you won't understand why you keep hitting obstacles that you can't get around. When the fear shows up initially, you're gonna hit obstacles. You're gonna have things, you're gonna lose things. You might lose employees or business partners, or you know, your business might lose some. There's gonna be a certain amount of loss, but what that is doing is that is actually dropping away what is no longer in alignment with your next level power. It's opening up space so that you can bring in new people, new relationships, new opportunities that is gonna level you up beyond what your mind can comprehend, okay? Mind is a great executor. Your mind is awesome. Your mind has helped you build what you have already built and is gonna continue to do so. But in these times of fear, your mind is your worst enemy. In the times of this expansion, I should say, the expansion into your next level power, your mind is your worst enemy. And what you're gonna wanna do is drop it into your body. Okay, just be like, okay, here I am. Get present, take a little time. Let it move through you. Let it go through its process. Let it have it say, thank it. And then as it begins to move away on its own organically, that's when you're stepping into your power and the next level version of yourself. If you ignore your fear, you sacrifice your power. Don't ignore your fear. Don't succumb to it. Don't play its game. Own it. Level with it. Thank it. And watch how your world expands beyond anything that you have been able to comprehend, because that is a level of power that you possess. All right, darling. I hope that's been helpful for you. If this is something you've been going through, we want to hear about it. Tell us what you think. Tell us about your experience. We're all here to learn from each other, and I appreciate you so much.